Good evening and welcome to the Conigliaro Gymnasium, home of Spartan basketball, for the consolation round in Division One of the Spartan Classic, fourth annual boys version. Lynn English taking on Beverly. They just played each other about a week ago. Beverly had a big win. English fell behind by 20, came back and tied the game against Springfield Cathedral, and then came up short by 4 points. Beverly ran into a buzzsaw at Malden Catholic. So they're playing for the consolation round. Beverly has, English is trying to get even with Beverly. Beverly beat them at English in a non-league game because Beverly still in the Northeastern Conference. English moved over to the Greater Boston League last year. For English, Tyrese Melo Garcia coming off a huge 43-point game as number one. Jesse Maggs is 11. Nelson Obasigabon is 14. Carmelo Boise is 0. And Yael Vizcaino is 22. And Beverly gets possession. Straight man-to-man. Shot, partially blocked. They save it. And we got a foul. And Nick Braganka is going to go to the foul line for 2 shots. The coach, Alvin Abreu, his first year for Lynn English, 13-5, doing a very good job. For Beverly, Matt Karakoudis. Matt Karakoudis is a former outstanding athlete, played his games right here at St. Mary's. He was a member of back-to-back state championships for St. Mary's in 2001, 2002. So he's back home at his alma mater. He played a lot of games here, now he's coaching here. Vizcaino to the basket, lays it in. Off the rim, no good. Vizcaino dropped it down. And Maggs going to the basket, gets fouled. The Spartan Classic was girls for quite a few years. As Maggs makes the free throw. The boys came on board in 2018, so this is the fourth. They didn't play last year because of COVID. This is the fourth for the boys. It's the first year for the boys that they divided into three divisions. The girls initially were Division One and Two. They went into three divisions. The boys were only one division three. Now they are now one, two, and three. Tyrese, they'll double him every chance they get. Off the rim, no good. Beverly with the rebound. They're gonna try and shut down the runner. Off the rim, no good. Tipped around. Everybody going for it. Buisi had it, but he was half inbounds and half out of bounds. We got a foul on Obasigabon. Beverly, when they played at English, they did a nice job. Tyrese Melo Garcia, they held them in check and they were able to beat English. Garcia with the basketball, they'll double him any chance they get. force him to give the ball up and let somebody else beat him. Nice fake. Omar Sigamore waited for the defense to go by and laid it in. And it's 5-2 English. Steps called. I was wondering if they were going to call it. English would like to get Garcia involved, obviously. Biscayne lost it. It goes to the floor, and oh, I think it was Buisi. It was Obasigabon who was out of bounds when he grabbed it. They throw it away, they doubled up inside. For Beverly, 3 is Dylan Crowley, 11 is Ryder Frost, 15 is Rook Landman, 21 is Nick Raganka, and 23 is Gabe Copeland. And there they go, doubling up Tyrese as soon as he gets the ball. Shot clock winding down, they gotta get it up. Biscayne took steps. So a slow start for both teams, 5-2, English. As we're approaching the halfway mark. Wide open. They missed the layup. He waited to take it, he was wide open. They go up court to Buisi and he lays it in. They made a great pass, great look, wide open, and just flat out missed a layup. Beverly with the rebound. They tie it up. Strong move to the basket by Copeland. He just fought through about three gray shirts and laid it in. 7-4, the Bulldogs over the Panthers. English Bulldogs, Beverly Panthers. Consolation round in Division I of the Spartan Classic. Coming up next is the game that everybody's been looking for. Springfield Cathedral against Malden Catholic in the final of this Division I. Both St. Mary's boys and girls are in the finals of their division. Girls have won it more often than not. The English girls are in the tournament for the first time in a while, and they're in the championship final. Tipped and knocked out by Beverly. Garcia trying to make the pass underneath. From dead in the corner. Garcia gets on the board with a 3. 10-4 English. Down the lane, the runner. They gave him the lane. Landman took it, laid it in. Three-point basket by Buisi. English by 7. Great pass inside. Sparkman with the layup. Off the pass from Copeland. Outstanding pass. Steps called against English. Coach Cavacutis from Beverly making wholesale changes early. Hook off the rim. Oba Sigabon gets tied up by Griffin Francis. It'll be English's basketball. 2:26 left in the first period. 13-8, English. Tyrese Garcia was going to take the shot. I think he got hit on the shot. He went up to take the shot, and he was going to get blocked. He bounced it down like a dribble. They got the ball back. He got it back, took the shot. He got hit. He'll get 2 at the line. He had a game for the ages, 43 points. He got 35 in the second half. He makes 1 out of 2. They almost threw it away. Shot. Up and good. Sparkman gets his second basket coming off the bench. Around the rim and hung, came out, went right back in again for Mags. Another basket by Sparkman over the head. Nice look inside by Copeland with the pass. Little wraparound, half hook over the head. 16-12 English, 1:26 left in the period. The crowd has been good in and out. This is the third day of the tournament. Each day, including today and tomorrow being Tuesday, there'll be 6 games played here at the Conegliaro Gymnasium. 24 teams getting involved. A lot better than scrimmaging or practicing before the state tournament. Neither team in foul trouble, 2 fouls apiece, team-wise. Fiscano will bring it up. And there they go, doubling up. As soon as he touches the basketball, they double up on him. Mag shot too strong. They tie it up. It'll be Beverly's basketball with the alternate possession. In and out. Inside with the rebound. Copeland waited for everybody to go by and then laid it in. Beverly cuts the lead to two. They're going to get Garcia for a push-off. He dribbled once and then gave a little shove to the defense and he got caught. Beverly can just about run out the clock. If they get a douche, we'll end in a tie. Taken away. Mags winds up with it. And they throw the ball away. So again, Beverly can take the last shot. Tough shot. At the buzzer, he throws it off the rim. So English led throughout, and they lead at the end of one. English 16, Beverly 14. All five starters for English have scored. Buisi leading the way with five. Jesse Maggs throws it in. Beverly had four scorers. Sparkman coming off the bench. Gave Beverly a spark, he got six. Off the rim, no good. Beverly with the rebound, misses the shot. Omar Sigibon with the rebound. Throws the pass away. They wrap it around, they save it. Oba Sigibon with the big block. Nice pass. Garcia gave it to Viscano. 4-0 run for England. He's got the lead up to six. Off the rim. Oba Sigibon with another rebound. We got a foul outside on the drive. Viscano going to the basket. Anderson. Josh Anderson coming in for English. Knocked out by Beverly. So 4-0 run to start this second period has built the lead up to six. Dribbling behind his back, they took it away. And we're gonna foul against English. Garcia has to know that they're going to be doubling him anytime he touches the ball. And he just took the ball away. Tipped away. They blocked the shot. In and out. Buisi took the rebound away. And he's all right now. He looked like he was limp a little bit. Shot, no good by Garcia. Shot doesn't go, but Landman will get two at the line. Looking to put Beverly on the board here in the second period. Took him almost 2 minutes. Two free throws by Lamon. English leads by four. Garcia with the basketball. And we got an offensive foul against English. Mitchell Purtis coming in. Oh, Beverly can get a little closer. They dump it inside. Great pass. Sparkman gets his eighth point. Great pass by Landman inside. And it's 20-18. Beato in for the first time with the basketball. They kept dribbling the basketball. They kept letting him go, and he finally says, I guess I'll throw it in. Three-point basket by Crowley. And we're going to foul against Beverly. And again, Matt Calacutis making frequent changes. I'm not sure what that was all about. Piscator was upset. It looked like they called two fouls on the play, one on each team. So Beverly will be shooting free throws the rest of the half. Beverly has one foul to waste. Trainer Gagnon doing some last minute repair on Viscano's arm. I think that's what it was. He might be having some blood, a cut, or whatever. And the official saw it. Both trainers working on Viscano. And Viscano has to go out. And Glory Cabongo will come in. Now we got Garcia being held off. I don't know what that was all about. Garcia got upset about something. They pull him aside. The official talking to him as well. And he's going to the sideline. And Viscano will come back in. And now Viscano can't come back in. So Buisi's going to come back in. Official's getting deeply involved in this first half. Beverly picks it off. They throw it the length of the court. They get fouled from behind. And Sparkman, who's been a spark for Beverly, has a chance to give him the lead. They haven't led in the game. English has held on to the lead. But they got a chance now. Misses the first. Maggs is back. Viscano's back. Garcia's back. .504 left in this first half. Sparkman could get a tie. Missed them both. Anderson with the rebound. So Ingles holding on to the one-point lead. And here's the double team on Garcia. Viscano got in close, missed the shot. And they're going to get Viscano for the foul. And that's going to put Beverly at the line. think it'll be Braganka. He'll get 1-on-1. 4:47 left. Beverly will be shooting two after this. English will be in double penalty with the next foul. Missed the shot. Tipped up from Johnson to Garcia. And the pass is picked off. Walking in and laying it in is Francis. And Beverly has their first lead. 23-22. Strong drive. I kind of shocked they didn't call a foul or a travel. Four in a row by Francis. This is Beverly, a three-point lead. I think you can tell there's a lot of Beverly fans in the stands. They're having a great year. They lost their first game to an outstanding Walden Catholic team in the first game of this tournament. They were 19-0 coming in to this tournament. They'll obviously be a high seed in the tournament, assuming they give a good grade to the Northeastern Conference League, because the records really don't mean anything right now. It's the strength of the league you play in. Used to be automatic. 19-1, you automatically get one or at least two home games. Now, you could be playing on the road. Right at the halfway mark of this second period. Yato will inbound it to Biscano. As Beverly has grabbed a three-point lead. English with only 6 points in the period. And they're looking right away to double-team Garcia. He almost threw it away. Beverly knocked it out. They're not going to let Garcia beat him. They're going to let somebody else from English beat him. Yeah, we got a foul as they were manhandling Garcia as he's trying to get the basketball. So English will be shooting free throws. Beverly will be shooting two. English will be shooting 1-on-1. It's the last 3:44. Up and good. That was Oba Sigabon. English creeps back within one. And Frost throws in a three to get it back to four. So English gets back within one very quickly. Frost hits the three. There's the double on Garcia. Omar Sigabon lost it out of bounds. Anderson is coming back. Stolen away by Garcia. The ball's on the floor. They're going to call a jump ball. It'll go to Beverly. Garcia picked it, couldn't grab it. It laid on the floor. Maggs is used to going down and recovering fumbles, being a strong member of the English football team. Because now they look like they're in a 1-3-1 zone. Anderson is going to get called for going over the top. Copeland will get two at the line. English is in double penalty. That one was down, came back out again. He makes one. Viedo couldn't hit it. Save. He didn't save it. They said he was out of bounds. Johnson said it would have gone to Beverly anyway. The difference is 5, and Beverly has outscored English 5-1 from the free throw line. And Beverly wants a timeout. So both teams have used 2 of their 5 timeouts. 2:16 left in this first half. Beverly trailed for most of the half. They made a little comeback here in this second period to grab a 5-point lead, holding English to 8 points, putting up 15. English led by 2 at the end of 1. They've held Garcia to 1 basket, 4 points. A 3 and a foul shot. And anytime he touches the ball, he's getting double teamed. They don't care if anybody's open. They want anybody but Garcia to beat him. Dead in the corner, off the rim, no good. Beverly gets the rebound. They line up the 3, off the rim again. Johnson, it gets kicked out. Johnson was going to make the pass down court. Bieda was all by himself. It got blocked by Beverly. It got kicked out by Garcia. So Beverly gets the ball back. Nice fake going to the basket. Landman faked the defense. They stepped away looking for the pass, and he made the layup. Beverly has their biggest lead of the game, 7. And there's the double on Garcia. Toscano trying to avoid the defense, stepped out of bounds. He tried to go inside, Bieto took it away. And then it got knocked out. They said it went off Bieto. In and out, tipped back away from Beverly. Great pass inside, they missed the layup. And it goes out off Beverly. Copeland made another terrific pass inside to Francis. He missed the layup. English got a break there. The wraparound by Garcia. He finally gets loose and gets a basket. Cuts the lead to 5. Beverly can almost run out the clock. Defense, 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 defense. 3-point basket by Landman. He's got 7 in the period. And the lead is up to 8. Biggest lead for Beverly in this first half. Garcia can't get loose. His pass is picked off. The buzzer sounds, that'll do it. Copeland threw it in, but it won't count. It was after the buzzer. So Beverly holds English to 10 in the second period. They were down 2, but they're going to take an 8-point lead into the locker room. It's Beverly 34, English 26 at halftime. Welcome back to the Conigliaro Gymnasium as we start the second half of this Division I consolation game. English will have the basketball. Beverly will have an 8-point lead. Beverly Landman had 9. Sparkman coming off the bench. Got 8 for Beverly, helping make a comeback. English had the lead most of the half, and then Beverly, it was 22-21 English. Beverly ended the half on a 13-4 run to get the lead up to 8, 34-26. And that's where we are. Buisi had 5. Garcia had 6. Around the rim and out for Mags. Beverly getting a few more people involved. Tipped away nicely by Mags. The ball goes to the floor. Around the rim and out, Garcia. They made the steal. That ball was hit every part of the rim, but didn't go down. We're going to jump ball. It'll be Beverly's basketball with the alternate possession. Strong drive to the basket by Landman. Picks up points 10 and 11. And Beverly has got the lead up to double digits. 36-26. English got to look to get the ball up. Shot clock winding down. Mags couldn't get the layup to go. Garcia takes it away and throws it in. Now Beverly throws it away. English, Garcia got it down to single digits. They can get a little closer here. And we got, Garcia didn't have a mask on. Now he has to go over and get one. It's kind of a joke because I'm looking at the people out in the court. Most of them that have a mask aren't really wearing them. Strong drive, Garcia's got 4 in a row. They've got the mask on, but they got it down, hanging down around their neck, nowhere near their face. Steps called. Took 3 running strides. Well, English can close the gap a little bit. Yeah, we're going to get a foul on Beverly. He's grabbing, holding on to Garcia. Lefty by Mags, tough shot. off the rim, no good. Mash with the rebound. Biscano gets hit. Landman reaching for the ball. All he got was Biscano. Ingles will have the basketball. Again, they can close the gap. Garcia took steps. Should I take the three? Should I go to the basket? And he wound up taking an extra step. Tough shot, Mags with the rebound. Around the rim and out by Mags. English can't get a break. Great pass inside. Bachman got the basket thanks to the pass by Copeland. He's made a few of those. There's the double on Garcia again. But he goes to the basket and throws it in. He had six in the first half. He's got six in the first 4 minutes here in the third period. And the lead is six for Beverly. They hesitated, and the hesitation paid off because it was Frost picking off the air ball and laying it in. Off the rim, no good. Garcia was able to come back and get it. The basket is good. Garcia was out of bounds. He came back in. The shot came off the rim. He came back in, stepped on the court, grabbed it, went to the basket, laid it in, and he's got a chance for a three-point play. He had that huge second half against Springfield. And he's off to a pretty good start here in the second half here with 8 points, looking for nine. He's got English back within five. This was a game at English that Beverly won very easy. That pass didn't get through. Inside, great pass. They missed the layup. Omar Sigibon, great pass from Garcia, and he missed the layup. And it winds up with a three-point basket. Crowley gets his second three. Garcia made a great pass. Omar Sigibon's coming to the bench, putting his two hands over his head, saying, I can't believe I missed that shot. It would have cut the lead to three. Instead, it goes back up to eight with the three-point basket by Crowley. Beverly's got 3 3-point baskets. Crowley's got two of them. Parisi has the only three for English. 3 minutes straight up to play in this third period. English hanging around. They were run off the court at English by Beverly. We told the English playing Springfield Cathedral, whose only loss came from a game in Connecticut. They were down 20 in the third period. They came back and tied it. And free throws by Springfield at the end gave them a 4-point win. Garcia went off in the second half. He wound up with 43 points. 37 in the second half. That was a no-look pass, and he should have looked. Copeland takes it. Garcia got stuck, had to get rid of it. Garcia drops it in. Tough drive to the basket by Frost. Just get back at his man in, threw the lefty in. And the lead is 10. Garcia for three. 14 points in the third period by Garcia. Cuts the lead to 7. And I'm not sure what they're doing now. They're kicking everybody off the stage. I don't know whether they were heckling the officials or the officials stopped and said, everybody off the stage. I don't know what that was all about. But they kicked everybody off. Off the rim, no good. 3-point basket by Garcia. Back to back, he's got English within 4. Short, no good. They take it away. And Frost lays it in. Garcia just going off here. We got a foul against Beverly. Garcia's going to the line for 2. He's come off here in the third period. 17 points in the third period. He likes the second half. Give him 18. Now give him 19. He's got English back within 4. Blocked and taken away. Garcia paid too much attention to Frost looking to block the shot and he missed the layup. And they get a wraparound by Sparkman. It's another 3. And the lead is 3. Almost stole that pass. Shot clock is off. Around the rim and out. At the buzzer, he almost threw that one in. 22 points in the third period by Garcia, and English has cut it back. They were down as many as 10. They're down three, and they'll have the basketball to start the final 8 minutes. 51 Beverly, 48 English at the end of three. English has the basketball, Beverly has a three-point lead as we start the final 8 minutes. 22 points for English in the third period. 22 points for Garcia. Too strong with the jumper. Up and good by Landman. The basket by Maggs. English hanging around, down three. Too strong with the layup, but he got hit. And Sparkman has certainly been a spark. He's got 12 points. Missed that one. So it's a 4-point game. Maggs going to the basket, threw it in. He's got four in a row. English is within two. Three-point basket. That one by Copeland, he's having a very nice game. He's got 10, and he's got a bushel of great passes. Garcia trying to get loose to double up on him. They almost gave it away. Maggs fumbled it. Viscano throws it in. All of a sudden, English can't miss. Stripped away. He dribbled. I think they said it got knocked loose. Everybody was looking for a double dribble. Three-point basket by Frost. So English made a couple of comebacks. They got back close. They cut it to one. And then two big threes, one by Frost, the other one by Copeland. And the lead is back up to six. And unbelievable, 22-point third period by Garcia. Again, he did it at Springfield, and he did the same thing here in the third period. And I said at the same time, he could drop kick the ball, it would go in the basket. He couldn't miss. He was throwing them in from everywhere. Beverly's trying to take the ball out of his hands by double teaming him. But then they got Maggs with four in a row and then Viscano with a shot. So they're hanging around. And this is a Beverly team that beat English by, I think it was over 30. It was a runaway at Lynn English. Garcia, stripped and taken away by Copeland. He made the defensive play, now he makes it offensively, coast to coast and lays it in. The lead is back up to eight. Viscano can't hit it. What about Sigibon? Hustles and gets it. The shot won't go. Knocked out by Viscano. Great hustle by Orbar Sigibon to save that. Mags' shot hung on the rim and fell out. English going full court press. Easy bucket for Frost off the nice pass again by Copeland. He's got a bunch of assists. The lead is back up to 10. Another three. He's got 31 points. Foul will be against Beverly. English only committed one team foul. If they were winning, that would be a huge advantage. But if we get down to the closing moments, if they have to foul to get the ball back, they'll run a lot of time off the clock trying to get in Beverly at the line. Viscano, he passed it to Mags, had his back turned. Viscano made the pass, it hit Mags in the back. Viscano got it back. Coach Abreu wants a timeout. Not quite halfway through, 16 seconds shy of halfway through this fourth period. English led through most, like a period and a half. They were leading 22-21. Beverly went on a 13-4 run to open up an 8-point lead. They got the lead into double digits in the third period, and Garcia went to work getting 22 points in the period to get them back. They were back within three at the end of the third period. And two big threes, one by Frost and one by Copeland. Pushed it a little bit, and now Beverly's got it back up to 7. They had it up to 10. Off the rim, no good. Tough shot by Garcia there. Stolen away. They go down court. Off the rim, no good. And we got a foul at the other end against English. Just past the halfway mark. And I thought they were going to call a shooting foul, but saying no on the drive. So Beverly will get it out of bounds. Out deep to Frost. Wide open three. Copeland knocks it down. His second trifecta in the period. He's got 15 points. Four Beverly players in double digits. Viscano looking to make the pass to Mags. He threw it too far out in front. I think he thought Mags was going to the basket. Mags was straightening up for a shot. So it's the lead is 10 and Beverly has the basketball. And we got a foul against English. Landman went coast to coast, missed the layup, got his own rebound. Time is the enemy now for the Bulldogs. They trail by 10. We're closing in on 3 minutes left. Frost takes a Sigabon inside and draws the contact. Frost will get two at the line. He's played well. He's got 6 in the period. Copeland's got 8 in the period. English only has 9 in the period. 15 points for Copeland and Frost in the period. And that has helped Beverly lead, push the lead to 12 with 3 minutes left. And English can't afford to run the clock. They got to score. Biscayne strong, can't hit it. Knocked out by Beverly. He get in the lane, but couldn't get the ball to fall. Inside, swatted away. Sparkman, Johnson had an easy layup. Sparkman just said, not in my house. He just whacked it away. What a job he's done. He's taking a little too much time. Short, no good. Assegaborn came up with the rebound. Great hustle by Assegaborn. He worked hard for those two free throws. Got a shot in traffic, went into traffic, rebounded it, fought everybody off to get control of the ball. Got hit as he's trying to put it back. He'll get 2 at the line. Missed the first. English is running out of time. They're down 12 with 2:23 left. Off the rim, no good. Another 3 by you-know-who. They're back within 8, but there's only 2 minutes left. Beverly can use up clock and not give English a chance. Shot got blocked. Biscayne lays it in. They have a pulse, but it's a faint pulse. They're down 6. Great pass. That last basket by Trask. Oh, excuse me, Crowley. And that probably put the nail in the coffin. It's an 8-point lead with 1:23 left. So it's 3 possessions. 2 of them would have to be 3-point shots. And that's without Beverly running any time off the clock or scoring. But English again, they played 2 great games here. They came all the way back against an outstanding Springfield team to tie it late and lose in the closing seconds on free throws. They're playing a Beverly team that blew them away at English, and they gave them all they could handle here. Points in the second half for Garcia, 37 in the second half. Hobart Sigabon gets fouled. Buisi saying they blocked the shot, but they hit the backboard in the rim. It should have been goaltending. So Alba Sigabon can get English closer with the clock stopped. But still, the clock is the enemy now. In and out. So it will still be three possessions. Beverly really doesn't have to shoot the ball. They can just run the clock down. Shorten the game up. They don't need any more points. The fall away off the rim. English gets it back. Pescano got his own rebound, lays it in and gets fouled. But it's just too little too late. And I mentioned before, English not in foul trouble, and that's going to hurt. They have to commit three fouls to put Beverly at the line, and there's only 37 seconds left. If he makes this, they're only down four, but there's only 37 seconds left. So English is going to make another great comeback, but they're going to come up short again. Beverly just has to pull it out and hold it. English isn't fouling, and now they foul, and it's going to be too late. They're going to have to commit more fouls. They have to commit two more fouls to put Beverly at the line. So English plays two great games here at St. Mary's, and they're going to come up short in both. Garcia gives the foul, 23 seconds left. Now if they foul, Beverly would be at the line. But too little, too late, 23 seconds left. They get it to Frost in the backcourt. Pescano gives the foul. Frost will get one-on-one at the line with 19 ticks left on the clock. So two big comebacks, and they're going to come up short. Missed the shot. They're giving him another shot. English was in the lane. I'm not sure what they're doing now. They're discussing something with, they're putting the clock back to 19 seconds. And Frost will get another shot because English was in the lane. Around the rim and out. The follow up and good by Anderson. Cuts the lead to four. 73-69, 6.9 seconds left. So in the two games that Inga's played here at St. Mary's, they're going to come up 8 points short, all at the end of the game. Free throws have been the difference, a couple of big threes. Copeland with 8 big points, 2 big threes. Frost with 9. 17 points in the period by Frost and Copeland. 3 trifectas. Fiscano did what he could do, getting 7 in the fourth period. Garcia hit a couple of tries for 6. He's got 34. But they're going to come up short. And Beverly's going to sweep the series against the Bulldogs. Fiscano fouls right away. Frost will be back at the free throw line. But too little, too late. Beverly's going to pick up their 20th win of the season. They were undefeated coming into this tournament. One of the remaining teams in this area in Massachusetts undefeated, along with St. Mary's boys. In and out, Beverly gets the basketball and that'll do it. They commit another foul, but there's 3.8 seconds left. Copeland will get one-on-one at the line. These are just add-ons. In and out. So English is going to come up short again. They made another big comeback. Great effort by the Bulldogs. This is a team that beat them by, I think it was over 30 at Lynn English just a week ago. They played two outstanding teams. Springfield had only lost one game, and that was to a team in Connecticut. Beverly only lost one game, and that was to Malden Catholic, an outstanding team. Beverly has just beaten English by over 30. And English hangs right with them, and they come up short. A couple of big threes and free throws down the stretch. Beverly holds on to win it, 73-69. For Beverly, Frost had 18, 9 of them in the fourth period. Copeland had 15, 8 of them in the fourth period, and he had a bunch of assists. Sparkman had 13, Lamman had 13. Melo Garcia will be an all-star from Lynn English. Ryder Frost is the all-star from Beverly. On the English side, Buisi had 5, he played very well. Beato had 2. Jesse Maggs had a nice game with 9. Omar Sigabon had a really nice game. He had 6, but he had a load of rebounds as well. Fiscano had 11. Garcia had 34, 28 of them in the second half. 22 of them in the third period. And it winds up Beverly beating English for the second time. 73-69. A tough loss for the Bulldogs again. They played outstanding, but they came up short. English will go to 13-6. Beverly will go to 20-1. And both teams will wait to see who the opponents will be in the state tournament. So 73-69, Beverly over English. We hope you enjoyed it. I'm Don Hoffman saying we'll see you next time.